Okay, it's July 29th. It's 11:10 a.m. I wanted to show you the condition of my tomatoes all of a sudden here. I've cut off all these branches, these stems. Look at that. Look at the leaves in there. Look at the spots, brown spot on all these. This is the ones I had inside the house that were so healthy. This is the crap I bought from Kmart. They've got it too. I've sprayed them with water and baking soda, which is a natural remedy for a disease. Now I'm looking to see if it's spread over here. I just walked down the road a little bit and I see the trees are getting like that. Look at it. The trees did not get it from these plants. Look at these last two tomato plants from Kmart. They're just about completely decimated from that brown spot. Look at my beans there. Look at the leaves. Look at that. This is, I can't think of the name of this stuff. But anyway, it is that. This has been like this off and on though for since we planted the purple pole beans. I put the baking soda water on it and generally it comes back with fresh green growth on it. But it's no excuse for this. The heat has something to do with it, but not much. Not you know, heat's the heat. I've been coming down here my entire life in its 90s and 100s. And everything grows out in the open fields. Here they have a little bit of shade even here. Well, I want you to see these trees. I mean, look at the sunflowers. I'm gonna get off from the garden and look at the sunflowers. Look at them. Look at how they all look like they're dying. There's a few of them that are making it. But look at the rest of them. Look at the leaves even. Look at that. See, there's a few in the back there. Those are fresh. Those sunflowers, those tall ones there, I planted probably about 2 months after those others were out there. I planted those others around March. And then around the end of June, early July, I planted those others and look how tall they got. But see, those are separate plantings. Over there is the only place where they seem to be healthy. But you see, like I said, the brown spots on everything. Look at these dying. I was walking down the road here. And I come back up the road. I'm not going to go down it because this ditch is steep. But look at the leaves on here. Let me zoom in if I can on here. Look at the brown spots on all this. This is what it's looking like on the tomatoes and some of the other plants. Oh, it's on the sunflowers. Again, giggle all you want. Piss yourself if you have to, laughing. But this is the stuff that's it's spreading. You know, there's only two things. Well, there are two of three at least. I don't know the third, but here are two conditions. Fukushima, March 11, 2011. And the chemtrails that they've been spraying for the last 30 years or better at least, that has been widely documented. Okay, but look at these trees. Look at this is the next tree over. Different type of tree too, completely. But look at the leaves on there. Okay, they're side by side, so I'll give it that, okay? Now here's another tree. It's about 30 feet, 40 feet away from this one. Again, look at this one here before I leave this area. See the brown spots on these, how it's killing them? This tree is about 30 feet away. What is it? I was walking down the road here and I looked up and I saw it on the branches. It's not every branch, but it's getting on the branches and it spreads. It takes a while for it to spread completely through a tree. But if you look at some of this, I can't see on this viewfinder very good. Just in that general area, you might see a few leaves with brown spots on them. And they're decaying like. I walked over to the pecan tree over there, same thing. It's getting some spots on them. And some leaves are turning brown. This is 4 years here. This is the first year this has ever happened like this. You've seen what the tomatoes look like. I mean, those things were fairly healthy. Question the ones from Kmart, but still, the other two that are three that I had grown myself and brought out were healthy. But then you look at this stuff on these trees here. Look at the sky. You know, oh, look at the pretty blue. There's no fucking blue in that sky. Get that shit out of your head. It's a shade of blue, but it's not blue like it was. They have been spraying, systematically spraying these skies. They even admitted they screwed up, they went too far, that it's beyond the point of no return. But rather than stop, look, there's one of those spray motherfucking bastards up there now. I don't know if it's coming in on the screen. Look, underneath it, you'll see a jet going, it's going northeast. Nothing behind it. The one going southwest, there's a little bit of a line, a trail behind it. So you tell me, they're not trying to fucking kill the planet. They're killing the fucking planet. These insane inbred pieces of shit are wanting to merge with machines. They feel they're going to merge with machines. You and your families are going to die. Unless you want to keep laughing about that, you better start doing something. Talk to your Congress people and let them see this. It's got swearing on it, but you know what? If swearing is the one thing that bothers you so much and the systematic poisoning of this planet doesn't, you are a fucking moron. You know what? If there was a way, you should just kill yourself and get it over with so we don't have to worry about the useless idiots like you. But that's what's going on here. I showed you the garden. The plants were all great up until like 2-3 weeks ago. They started getting a little bit rotten. I was trying to treat them naturally and they were working. Now it's all eating up those plants. I walk down the road here. I see it all over these trees here. And then into this one. And then over there to that one. So it's something that's coming down, I say, from possibly the combination of Fukushima and the spraying they've been doing for at least the last 30, 40 years. So get your head out of your asses, stop laughing, and do something. Man, it makes me so sick. I swear to God, you better believe if I ever seen you and you say anything to me, I'd spit in your face because you're that stupid. It'd be like a breath of fresh air for you.